I think they're following us.
Private, get as many men as you can find. Tell them we've got an attack coming from within.
I told you weapons are useless against these creatures.
Maybe so, but it'll slow them down at least. Go, Private!
They're getting closer.
Please, somebody make it stop. Not fair. We know.
Get behind me, you two. I'll try to keep them back.
But for how long?
Doctor, it's doing something to the radio.
We know you. Time Lord.
This is it. The whole world has seen too much anger, too much bloodshed, and it has had enough. God tried to warn us, tried to warn me. I was too stubborn to see, too stubborn to understand. I am sorry, Lord. First you sent the box containing an angel, then the messenger, the old man who could predict the future, and brought fire from the sky when we tried to execute him. They were no American shells. I know that now. The messenger tried to tell me that the war would one day end, but I didn't understand, Lord. I thought you would be merciful, that you would convince those in power to stop fighting and find peace, but no, he meant today, the day you finally had enough and gave the world back our dead. The bodies of those we had killed for no other reason than we were told to, brought back to life before our eyes. I tried to stay calm, Lord, but we both know the truth. I have faced death every day for over 5 years, but I have never been more terrified than this evening. I was talking with the men in my foxhole when we heard them coming towards us through the snow, not stopping for our shouts or warning shots. Then we saw them, an army of our nightmares. German and American alike, blue from the cold and shambling towards us. We tried to fight them, but there were too many. We ran, even though I knew that running was pointless. Soon we could hear gunfire from the camp as the dead moved forward, snapping the necks of anyone in their path. In our terror, we that fled lost each other in the night, and now there is only me, Lord. And you, of course.
Time Lord.
There's so many of them. These aren't just the ones we buried.
No, my dear man. I'm afraid they aren't. Those ones you thought were dead were merely repairing themselves, biding their time for their main attack.
Doctor, what do we do? That voice.
I know, Robbie.
But that voice, it's saying Time Lord. It knows what you are.
It's just trying to scare us, Robbie.
Well, it's doing a pretty good job.
Trying to scare us. Yes! And it may just have played its hand a little too early. The radio! Of course! Robbie, come with me. Inside the tent, child.
Time.
Lieutenant, keep these things at bay for as long as you can, there's a good fellow.
Whatever you say, Doc.
I shall remind you not to call me Doc as soon as we're all out of this mess.
Time.
Now, Robbie, if we just... Robbie!
I've sorted it, Doctor.
Sorted it? You've smashed it to pieces.
It was controlling them, wasn't it? Am I right?
Right. You stupid girl. That radio was the only chance we had of fixing this mess.
Oh.
Doc! Running out of ammo, Doc!
I'm sorry, Doctor.
We can't stay here, Lieutenant.
You're telling me.
This wretched child has just... Oh, never mind that now. Which way was the TARDIS, Robbie?
I'm really sorry.
You can apologize later and many times over. Now where is it?
This way, I think.
Come along, Lieutenant.
We'll be right back. What are you waiting for? Do it. I am not resisting. Are you afraid? I knew it. I saw men like you in Normandy. We were told that America had the fiercest army in the world. That once you joined forces with our enemies, our days were numbered. Yet you are not born killers. That's what I told my men. An army of civilians, of farmers and mechanics. Not real soldiers. And now you stand over me, your pistol in your hand. A lieutenant. Finish it! Can't you hear me? Nothingness. Silence. Wait. Is this it? Did he do it? Is this what it is like? There is nothing? Am I? Wait. No. There is something. I'm not alone here. I am not alone.
They're everywhere.
Mein Gott.
Quiet, Fritz. Huntley, we the only ones left?
Looks that way.
Williams have anyone with him when they attacked?
Just me and those English medics. He sent me to find whoever I could.
Over to the left. Fire! There's too many to shoot.
You got a pistol, Lowry.
Here.
Catch, Jerry.
Duncan.
You nuts, Sarge?
We need all the help we can get. Now let's make a move. Lowry, take the crowd and head back for the LT. We'll cover you from here.
Wait!
I haven't seen one of these things shoot at us yet. Hey! Over here!
Lieutenant!
Good to see you, Private.
Robbie, are you okay?
I've been better.
Lieutenant, we were just coming to get you. These things are coming from everywhere.
The camp is overrun.
What's the plan?
The plan? The plan, my dear boy, is to do exactly what I tell you to do.
By the tree!
Could you mind not firing that dreadful thing right in my ear, young man? Dear me.
Why are we listening to this guy?
Because he knows what he's doing.
Thank you, Robbie. Quite. Now, much as I can appreciate you wanting to shoot everything in sight, all you're doing at the moment is wasting ammunition, and if we're going to stop all this...
We need to get back to that box, Sergeant.
But I thought you lost the key.
Lucky for us, I happen to have a spare. Or to be more accurate, I have the original. Lead the way, Robbie.
I'm not too sure. I came here in daylight.
It was this way. Follow me.
Where am I? Was it this way? Ah, yes. Here I am. I know what to do, Lord. The blue box this morning was your way of showing me, wasn't it? Where I needed to be for the coming judgment. Well, here I am. What should I do? Should I enter? Wait, who is that approaching? More of the devil's servants, Lord, taking over the bodies of my comrades and making them do his bidding. They haven't seen me. Oh no, they are taking your box, Lord, hoisting it up onto their shoulders and carrying it away as if they were carrying a coffin. What does this mean? What do I do now?
Well, where is it?
It should be right here. I remember. This is the place.
Should be, eh? It's all very well saying that time, but it isn't now, is it?
What could have happened?
Perhaps you haven't heard of Arkham's Razor. Now, what is more likely, That my ship disappeared of its own volition, or that you and this young man have simply gotten us lost?
No. This is the correct spot, all right. Someone must have taken it.
Stuff and nonsense!
Doctor, look at the ground! You can see the spot where the TARDIS was when I left, and there's footprints, dozens of them!
Kraut boots, sure enough. No way of telling if they were alive or dead.
Doctor, we can just follow them to find the TARDIS.
And even if you're right, what then? It could be heavily guarded by now, if it was even here in the first place, which I am not conceding for a minute.
Why are you being so difficult?
Difficult?
You used to listen to me.
I'm sorry if the situation is leaving little time for polite chit-chat, Robbie, but right now, all you need to do is what I'm telling you and stop complaining.
Quiet, both of you. I still don't know who either of you are, but right now there's only one person in charge, and that's me. So you will stop arguing and listen to my orders. Is that clear?
Of all the nerve.
Right. Let's take stock. As far as we know, only me, Sergeant Finnegan, and Privates Lowry and Huntley made it out of the camp alive. We've got one prisoner... Who gave the crowd a weapon? And you two, who claim you can help, but so far, you've done nothing but bicker at each other.
I never bicker.
And I've had enough! My company has been all but wiped out tonight, and that would be bad enough if I had the slightest idea what was going on! Now you had better tell me right now who you are and how you can help us, or so help me, I will kill you both where you stand.
One thing I will tell you, young man, is that I do not answer to threats like that.
Doctor, this is serious. They deserve some answers.
Over there.
Leave it to me.
Wait.
Out of the way, Fritz.
Don't shoot. I know him.
And I've seen men I know trying to tear me to pieces tonight. Get out of my way.
I wouldn't be so hasty, young man. Look at the way he's walking towards us. He's still alive.
Still a kraut. Sir?
Stand down, Private. Hey, you! Kommen Sie hier! Schnell!
Simon!
Ernst, is that you? You are alive?
Drop the gun, now! Hands in the air!
It is you, the man from the future, and the angel. Have you come to rescue me?
Yes, yes, my dear fellow. Come here.
Watch him.
Lieutenant, can't you see this man is at his wit's end?
Sir, if he was a pointsman, there could be more of them.
No, I don't think so. If he were part of a patrol, he wouldn't have approached us so readily. Am I right, What are you doing out here?
You told me the war would be over one day, but I didn't think you meant it like this.
Like what? What have you seen?
You think they got hit as well?
That'll teach them. So much for Jerry's secret weapon.
Do be quiet.
They came out of the snow, hundreds of them. Americans and our own people we thought were dead. The dead have joined forces against us. Who put them there? God himself has had enough of this world.
Exactly the same as what happened to your camp, eh, Lieutenant?
If he's telling the truth.
And it's my fault.
Hush, young man. How could it possibly be your fault?
I prayed for him to end this war, to end everything. Just to stop this torment. Don't you understand? I asked him to end the world for my sake, because I couldn't carry on anymore. I was so weak.
Come now. There are many different kinds of strengths and weaknesses in this world. You can see beyond the here and now. You don't follow your leaders blindly. That says a lot in this time and place. And you can believe me when I say this isn't your fault. Not remotely.
Thank you again.
Enough of this. We have things to do.
Who is that? Who is there?
Only me, Major Herman.
I can't see you. Van, what is this place? Am I...
dead? Yes. What is left of your consciousness is being kept in a holding pattern. I am scanning your memories. Such a long life, filled with violence. Ah!
Who are you?
You have spoken to the one I seek more than any of the others. The Time Lord. Where is he? The old man you took prisoner. Answer me!
I will not. But you have to threaten me, death. You cannot cause me pain or injury, and I no longer have the fear of death.
There are worse things than that, human. I can release this holding pattern in a split second, and you will cease to exist.
Then do your worst.
I don't believe a word of it.
I know it sounds impossible, but it's the truth. Trust me, 6 months ago, I would have said the same thing.
I believe you. I've seen enough today to know a lot of things can happen that seem impossible.
Even if this machine of yours could have helped you, Doctor, it's vanished. So we're back to square one.
Not exactly. You have my expertise at your disposal.
Then what do you plan to do?
What I need is a radio. The one in your camp would have sufficed if Robbie here hadn't destroyed it. The men rising from the grave are being controlled by a signal. Hence the voices we all heard. That was the feedback. The minds of those killed being kept somewhere so the bodies can be manipulated. And if I had access to a working radio, I should be able to make certain modifications and track the signal back to its source.
And then we can destroy it?
Precisely, my dear. Precisely.
That's all very well, but I can't put all my faith in some crackpot scheme like that. My first priority has to be to my men.
Meaning?
Meaning you're free to do what you want, but we are going to head back to the camp, try and round up any survivors, then get back to Baston ASAP. There will be a radio there you can use. You want to come with us? We'll keep you safe.
Lieutenant, this problem is bigger than just this petty war. If we don't act quickly, the whole universe could be at stake.
Petty war? How dare you?
Yes, yes, petty. This war might seem big to you, but I've seen conflicts that would make this look like a card game. Look, look up at the sky. You see that constellation? It is a star that is home to 7 worlds. At least, it was. It isn't there anymore. Remember the Santans, Robbie? They and the Rutans fought a war over that system for hundreds of years. And about a decade ago, the Santans used a weapon that turned the star into a supernova. The system evaporated. Trillions upon trillions of life forms died. But you won't see it from Earth. Not for, 1,000 years at least. And when you do, it'll be a bright spot in the night sky, here for over a year. A testament to that day echoing throughout the universe. You think it'll remember this war as well as that? Pah!
Well, it might not mean a lot to you, but bringing my men home safe means more to me than any of that mumbo-jumbo. You want to come with us to Baston and find a radio? That's fine. But me and my men are leaving right this second, whatever your decision.
Excuse me?
Yes, my good friend. What is it?
You said you needed a working radio. Our lines are less than 20 minutes walk away. There is a radio in the Major's tent.
Excellent news! You can show me the way.
Doctor, it sounds as if they were attacked too. Their camp could be crawling with those things.
Well, if we accompany the Americans, we will likely have to deal with them in any case. I would say this German camp sounds like our best bet, yes.
As I said, you go where you want. We're still going to Baston.
Then I think this is where we part company, Lieutenant. I will take these two gentlemen to show me the way.
What about me, Doctor?
Like you said, Robbie, the German camp can be highly dangerous. Your best bet is to stay with these American gentlemen.
But, Doctor...
Now listen to me for once, child. Ahem.
Doctor, I need to stay with you.
I'm desperately sorry for getting you into this, Robbie. But with the TARDIS missing, I've no way of taking you back to your own time. I'll do my best to stop all this, but if I don't make it back...
Doctor, I want to help you.
If I don't make it back, you'll be safest with these gentlemen. You'll be able to get back to England and have as good a life as you can. Oh, I know it's not your own time, but you'll survive well enough into the 20th century, won't you? Lieutenant, look after this young lady, will you?
She'll be safe with us. But, Doctor, I can't let you just take two of my prisoners back to an enemy camp.
Prisoners? Still playing that silly war game, are we?
Sergeant?
Sir?
You're to escort these three to the German lines.
Yes, sir.
If it looks like this doctor is telling the truth, give him all the help you can. If they try anything funny...
Understood, sir.
I wish I could have faith in your plan, but I can't put all my eggs in one basket. When we get back to Baston, I'm going to ask for a heavy bombardment of this entire area, as much firepower as they can spare.
Young man, have you listened to a word I've been saying? You can't stop these things with all the firepower in the world.
You fight them your way, Doctor, and I'll fight them mine.
A bombing raid? But what if they're still out there?
Then I'm sorry, but I don't have a choice. Good luck.
I have it. Do you see? I am showing it to you now.
Ah, it hurts!
Do you recognize it? The blue box?
I do not talk.
I have the Time Lord's TARDIS. He cannot leave this planet without it. But I need the Time Lord himself to gain entry. Where is he? Where is the Time Lord?
I think we must be nearly there, Doctor.
It is not much further. See here, our forward positions.
Abandoned? Nobody so. Of course.
This was our foxhole. The fire is still burning. We were cooking soup when they struck.
Feels strange being here. Like when we took that farmhouse in Normandy. We stormed in and found them eating breakfast.
We ate well in France. Not like here. Here, it is watery soup and stale bread. Is it same for you?
Just keep walking, Fritz. You really think you can stop this, Doctor?
Hmm?
You've barely said a word the last few minutes. You all right?
I'm worried about my young friend. I shouldn't have gotten her into this.
From what I know of Robbie, I think she makes her own decisions. She'd be here right now beside you, if you hadn't stopped her.
That's as maybe, young man.
I know you just want to protect her, but trust me. You did the right thing. She'll be safe in Bastogne. Safer than out here, at any rate.
But it's not as simple as that. Oh, it's hard to explain. I invited her to travel with me.
And she accepted.
Yes, but it wasn't me she wanted to travel with. I used to be different. Oh, you wouldn't understand, young man.
The camp is just up ahead.
So, we are here. Never thought I'd be taking this place by myself.
Halt! Lowry, get the map. We must be here. That look right to you?
Yes, sir.
If we want to cover as much of the camp as we can, we need to go this way.
Sir, isn't there more chance of running into trouble that way?
Maybe, but our priority has to be to look for survivors.
How about...
Quiet. Over there.
There's so many of them. What do we do?
Don't panic. They could be ours.
They're heading this way, whatever they are.
I don't think they're friendly. Some of them have German helmets.
Stay down. Keep quiet and let them pass us by.
Look at them marching. A few hours ago, they were like mindless animals. Now they're walking in time, like a patrol. If we stay here, they'll find us.
What are you doing, Private?
I'm going to lead them away. When I make a run for it, get out of here.
Stay down, Private. That's an order.
It's our only chance.
Private Lowry, get back here at once.
Hey! Over here! Come on!
He'll get himself killed!
They've seen him. Come on, we can't stay here.
We can't just leave him.
We have to go. He's giving us a chance. Let's not waste it. Run!
Well, we appear to have the place to ourselves, don't we? Excellent.
Lot of spent shell casings and blood on the ground.
They would have put up a fight.
Or maybe most of them ran away, like that one over there.
No, I can feel it. They all died here.
Even if they all got up and walked away, where are they?
Let's not waste time wondering about that. Our enemy has let its guard down, and we must take full advantage. Now, Ernst, was it?
Yes?
Show me where this radio is. There's a good fellow.
This way. I think it was... Yes, here. The tent on the left. I'm sure of it.
Excellent. I shall only need a few minutes. Now, where did I put my... Oh, yes, that dreadful German took it from me, didn't he? Well, no matter. I should still be able to cobble something together. You men, stay here and keep an eye out for any of those things returning.
Freezing out here.
Cigarette?
Thanks.
The old man. Do you believe he can stop all this?
I don't know.
I believe he's the only one who can.
Now, where is it, hmm? Which frequencies are you using?
No. I will not talk. I don't know! No.
That poor fellow. What are they doing to you, hmm?
I knew it. Every man has his breaking point. These memories hurt, don't they? Trapped overnight in no man's land. Just you and the man you killed. He was your foes, wasn't he?
I wasn't scared.
There is no use pretending with me. You tried for years to forget, didn't you? You watched the rats eat the flesh from his body all night. You tried to bat them away, but still they kept coming. And the letter? You went through his pockets, didn't you? You needed to know his name. You found the last letter he wrote to his family, and you kept it. You read it even though your English was poor at the time. His family never got that letter, did they? You kept it with you until you could stand it no longer, and then burnt it that summer after the war ended. You thought that would be the end of it, didn't you? But I never forgot.
Stop it!
Then tell me where the Time Lord was going. What was his plan? You were so badly wounded that your last few memories are hazy and incomplete. Where is he? Wait, is it? Move closer. Where are you? Yes, the German camp. Is that him? Hiding in a tent, surrounded by three scared children. Move closer.
Let me go!
Let me go! You have what you want. What do you need me for? No! No!
Dear me, I wonder who he's arguing with. Let's see what we have here. Yes, this should work.
Doctor!
What is it now? Is there a problem? Oh, dear.
They've stopped. They were moving towards us, but they've stopped.
Mein Gott.
We appear to be surrounded.
I've got one clip. You three get out of here. I'll...
This isn't the time for futile gestures, boy. I'd rather think if they were going to attack us by now, they would have done so, don't you think?
Then what are they waiting for?
Time Lord.
What?
Time Lord.
I think you have the wrong man.
We can see your heart beating, Time Lord.
I see, indeed.
You will come with us.
Never.
You will come with us, or the humans will die.
Very well. I had best go with him.
We can still get out of here if we're quick.
No, I'd hazard a guess that they're going to take me to whoever's behind this mess, and that's who I need to talk to.
All the humans will come with us.
Let them go. It's me you need, not them.
They will come with us, or they will die here and escort you under my control.
We'd best go with them, gentlemen.
We're getting close to Bastogne.
Not before time. I can't feel my toes.
Huntley, take point and... Robbie, get down!
They shot him!
Stay down! It's one of ours!
Oh.
Lay still, Huntley. You're going to be all right. Hey! Hold fire! Hold fire! It's Lieutenant Williams from Dog Company! We need to speak to Colonel Burns immediately! And we need a medic! Don't move, Huntley. Everything's fine. Keep it together.
Gotta keep running. Can't stop. Where am I going? If I stop, they'll catch me. It's so dark, I can't see a thing. Where's the moon? It can't just have gone. No. Oh, please, no. I didn't get away, did I? This is it. I didn't get away. They caught me. I'm dead!
How can I be dead? It isn't fair.
Darn it all. This is Colonel Burns of the 101st Airborne. Can anybody read me? Over.
Sir.
Lieutenant. At ease. Who's this?
Robbie Peterson.
Sir, I regret to inform you that my company has been routed from our line. We were attacked by...
By who, soldier? Pull yourself together.
It's difficult to explain, sir. But I request a full bombardment of the area.
Difficult to explain? Lieutenant Williams, let me tell you what is difficult to explain. We've had no radio contact with anyone for the past 12 hours. The few reports we are getting are of American and German troops joining forces to overrun our positions, and none of our vehicles work. Now, what is happening to my division?
Sir, it appears as if... People are coming back to life, sir.
Coming back to? Have you lost your mind, Lieutenant?
It's true. We've seen it for ourselves.
And who the devil are you?
I told you. I'm from the United Na- Never mind. Just...
Lieutenant, from what I can see, we're dealing with breaking of the ranks on a colossal scale. And now you burst in here with some crazed, limey woman talking nonsense. I'm relieving you of command. Report to Lieutenant Peters and put both yourself and this young lady under arrest immediately.
We don't have time for this.
Who do you think you're talking to?
Lieutenant, look!
They must have followed us.
What the?
Do you believe us now, sir? Look out the window. Hundreds and hundreds of them coming toward us from out of the forest. We're surrounded.
What is this place?
Well, we appear to be in some sort of underground tunnel system. Thousands of years old, I'd say. I'm curious.
Why haven't they just killed us?
Who says they're not going to?
Now, if they wanted us dead, they could have done that back at the camp, couldn't they, Whoever's behind this must need us for one reason or another.
Then why do I get the feeling I'm not going to be leaving this place alive?
Don't talk nonsense! Now, quiet. We seem to be arriving somewhere.
At last! Welcome, Time Lord! Kneel before me!
Doctor, the old woman on the throne, who is she?
I don't know. But whoever she is, I'd say she seems to be in control of this walking travesties of life that have surrounded us.
I have been waiting for you, Time Lord. I've been expecting one of your kind for so long. So long. I knew it was only a matter of time before one of your cursed race visited this miserable little planet. And you've brought friends, I see. You actually find these poor creatures tolerable.
I do indeed. I think you'll find that if you spend some time with them, you'll find that they're actually quite marvelous.
Is that so? Then why are they tearing their planet apart? I've felt so much of their world today. They spew poison into the atmosphere, try to kill each other in their millions. These men either side of me would be tearing each other apart if they still had their own minds. And for what? Because they think they are different? But you think you can change them, don't you? I thought your kind were not meant to interfere. And yet, you have friends on both sides. You have convinced them to work together. Did you tell them they would be safe with you?
Doctor, this woman is possessed. The devil speaks through her.
So limited in imagination, aren't they? This one feels what I am, but cannot articulate it except through his own primitive belief system. His babbling irritates me. Guards! Kill the humans!
No! Don't you need them alive?
Their safety seemed instrumental in making you come quietly. However, now you are here.
No! You monster!
Bring the Time Lord closer!
Who are you? What are you? Tell me!
Who am I? That is a difficult question. Part of me was born Aya. Less than a mile from this spot. 2,000 years ago. Not long, but generations for these puny creatures.
And the other part? The part that is responsible for this mess that took over this poor woman's body? What are you?
Quiet! Perfect! I can still smell the energy coming off you. Oh, this is better than I could have ever hoped. You have regenerated, haven't you? Very recently. You're burning like a sun inside. At this stage, it's so easy to unravel.
No!
Why do you protest? You're barely here at all. going to pull this new body of yours apart at the seams. Oh, this is going to be delicious!
Every few thousand years or so, I will dig you out and help myself to a little more. I wonder how much of the universe I will control by then.
But the doctor had a plan.
Robbie, if the doctor's plan was going to work, it would have by now.
Shoot me! Shoot me! It is our only chance!
You should fear your death. You cannot hide from me forever. Patience is a particular virtue of mine.